Hey, I'm back. It's supposed to be recording. It didn't give me any indications that it's recording, like usual, you know. Because in this mod, for example, with like Data Shokan or Sharing, which this mod I use, it's like freezing for a second and then like it's fine, but not here apparently. But sorry, I hope it's recording here. This time, I heard the way. Ah, so I was that close. Okay. Some time had passed since the start of the new semester. The chili blossoms that were in full bloom had returned to being normal green trees. Whew. I stopped my bike and took off my helmet. The temperature had risen a bit, making it too hot to keep cycling without a break. Today, rather than going to the mountains, I simply cycled around town. Actually, I was supposed to cycle with Madoka, but she messaged me that she wasn't feeling well at the last moment. There was nothing either of us could do about a random cold, but I was still a little disappointed. Cycling was fun, but also kind of uneventful when you were alone. Marcus Dad seemed to still be busy. I hadn't seen him for a while now. Maybe I'll go to the mountains again next week. Sakura Mori stretched along the sea and was surrounded by the mountains. By mountains on the other side. These mountain roads were perfect for cycling, and you could spot many joggers running along them every day. Hopefully your cold will be gone by next week. I ended up finishing earlier and turned home. I hooked up the bike and went inside. I'm home. It had become a habit to talk to the empty house ever since my parents passed away. I wouldn't usually gawk out the window, but today I was kind of curious about Madoka's condition. During the day, she'd have the curtain closed, making it very hard to see inside. Though one mercury glance was enough to tell she was up and moving around the room, much to my relief. Have you gotten used to school yet, Hatsune?
もうだいぶ部活にも入ったし。結局何部にしたの? 家庭科部。うん。家庭科部か。お裁縫とか?
I guess general things, yes.
うん。あと料理を作ったり、お菓子を作ったり。
Oh, that's nice. Oh, and then when you went into that, Hatsune? Hatsune gave me a wacky note. I was almost living with her, yet I somehow wasn't familiar with her interests or hobbies. I'd never even been to her room since we slept in different houses.
Hey, Mama, next Wednesday, you can teach me to cook?
Okay.
Miss Miyako was really good at cooking, so we always had amazing dinners. Hatsune would improve right away with her institution.
Nisa, next Wednesday, are you free?
I think I'll be cycling.
Wakatta.
Give me a sec. Alright. Bye.
Bye bye.
Oyasumi. Sono uchi kikai mo aru wa yo.
Right.
Shinji-kun ni te ryōri o furumau kikai?
Oh, sono uchi ka.
So aseru koto mo nai n janai? Hatsune-chan, ryōri nante mada shita koto mo nai n da shi.
I mean, yeah, you need to actually know what to do.
Sore mo sou da ne.
Exam Madoka was walking with steady steps, but her face was... Her face still seemed to be somewhat pale. Did your cold pass yet? That wasn't it? Then did you have a food poisoning or something? Is it the usual? Don't tell me you got hurt. I looked Madoka up and down. She walked steadily and her arms moved naturally. Right. Okay then. You think you'll be able to ride next Sunday?
多分ね。
Great! Now let's go to the... hotel next time?
いいよ。
Sorry about it. Yeah.
二人の趣味はロードバイクで、休みの日はよく走っているようです。本当は、私も混ぜてほしい気持ちはあるんだけど。一つには、運動神経も悪いから腰が引けてしまうということがあります。でも、そんな理由は、本当は二の次で。
Now, at least you realize that.
自分で言うのもあれですけど、遠慮しているのかもしれません。
ねえ、し。
それと、ひょっとしたら、仲良くしている二人を見たくない気持ちも少しは。
Yeah, I guess. We did some long distance running in our PE class today. I'm so tired. I liked going for long distances on my bike, but jogging just exhausted me. I almost felt jealous of Madoka for not having to participate. Yeah.Why? Huh? Why?
まあ、仮病でもないんだろうけど。だから、ほら、正義だよ。
I was so slow to catch on, it actually made me the conversation awkward.
いいよな。ダーリーマラソンとか水泳とか休めそうじゃん。けど、あんまりやったらバレんのかな。
I mean, yeah.
わからんけど。
But it's still kind of, you never know kind of thing, so it teaches, would be like, should I or should I not, you know? Right, we learn all about that in sex education. The teachers all had a pretty serious expressions on their faces when they told us to never tease a girl about it. I reflexively turned my head to the corner of the athletics field. A couple of girls, Madoka included, sat there on the grass watching us train ourselves.That does explain her odd behavior this morning. I returned my head to its natural position and then continued to run in silence. This was weird. I was never too sharp, but this was pushing me to my limit. Okay, time to go home. I walked along the corridors thinking about where I should ride today. But someone called out to me as soon as I passed through the school gates.
Shinji!
A dog?
今日はバレー部に出てもどうせ見学だからさ、一緒に帰ろうと思って待ってたんだ。
You could have told me in the classroom?
まあ、なんとなく。ねえ、今度の日曜だけど、やっぱりサイクリングはやめにしてお店に付き合ってくれない？
Trevin? That's fine, I guess.
私、ウェアが欲しくなっちゃった。
よし。え Like a jersey or something?
まあ。
It seemed like she wanted to say something more, but remained silent. It wasn't like I was dying to know what she wanted, so I didn't press the issue further.
今日は、妙に静かなのね。
Same to you? You think so?I just don't have anything to say.
Yutana?
What? Is that an impression of someone?
この前ドタキャンしちゃったからって、拗ねないの。
What? Sawkin?
来週…いや、再来週か。再来週はちゃんと付き合うからさ。
Okay.
あの、これからも、そうやって…急に行けなくなる時があるかもしれないけど、あんまり気にしないようにして。
I looked away from her eyes and nodded. Oh, I like this change here. Good morning!
おはよう。今日は結構遅いのね。サイクリングの時は大体早起きしていると思ったけど。
Yeah, the cycling plan got kind of cancelled, so... I'll be looking at cycling stuff instead! Right! I sit down at the table! Are you going to practice cooking today, Hatsune? What was up with you? She seemed pretty down all of a sudden. Okay, he's like 12, he doesn't get it, okay. 最初から人に食べさせられるようなものができるわけではないんだから。Okay. Azoka began walking right away. Her face looked just the right color today. I feel like it's been a while since we were out walking the streets like this. I mean, it's different when you're going to school. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe it's the clothes? Yeah. It just feels different. I had no idea why that made her happy, but she had a grin on her face as she cocked her head. I mean, I like it. Don't you wear that inside the house all the time? Also, yeah. Okay, that made complete sense, actually. The way you phrase it sounded like you were showing it to me for the first time or something. Huh? It felt like you were having trouble communicating today. Stop trying to sound like me in anyone! Right. Do you really want empty flattery like that? I ask her, unable to steal a smile. My smile kind of froze. I wet my eyes unequivocally. I'm not a fan of flattery. It was fake. What I really think? Couldn't help smiling again at that overconfident remark. Then I hardly ever did my eyes again. I felt like my face got grown a little more. Discount coupon?
10% off yo. 持ってこないと さすがにもったいないわよね.
I mean, yeah, I guess so. Okay, that's fine. Firstly, is it still half full? I don't remember the last time we were on the train.
So, ne.
Usually, we ride on our bicycles to move around. I would have been fine if we rode to the shop directly, but Madoka said she wanted to use the train today, so here we were. Yeah. Suddenly, I realized something odd. Huh? Did you use perfume? Right. I smelled a nice scent, but now it felt awkward to ask about. No. No, I definitely am not. I shook my head.
Hmm.
couldn't refuse that. There was really something off with me lately. I mean, no? Not really? I think you're fine just the way you are. After a little while, we finally reached the town center. That was where the cycle shop was, we frequented Nakagawa was located. Monoko headed straight to the sports corner as we entered. There was nothing I needed, so I ended up just following her. I guess I was. It kind of felt like she wanted to get rid of me or whatever. It really didn't matter what kind of eyes I used, so I just bought the most generic looking one. I had nothing to do after placing the merchandise in the basket. Might as well kill time by looking at random bicycle parts. I had received a very large life insurance payout after my parents passed away. But that was locked away in trust funds that I couldn't claim until I had reached adulthood. I said I couldn't quite afford most of the expensive parts for my average allowance. Well, hello there! Mr. Nakagawa, this shop's owner, was Madoka's dead friend, and through him we were fairly well acquainted. It's unusual to see you here. Are you on your own? Oh, I came with Madoka? Madoka? Ah, I see you in the sportswear corner. Most of you are in your street clothes. Did you come by train this time? Yes, I don't know why, but Madoka insisted on using the train today. Mr. Nakagawa gave me a light nod and turned his head toward Madoka's direction. But dad, I'm so jealous of you kids. I wish I could get a cute girl to keep me company when I suck at your age. Not that much has changed in my life since then. All my cycling buddies are stinking old man. You two are dating, aren't you? That's not the nature of our relationship. Mrs. Nagao patted me on the shoulder and moved to another customer. I headed to the register. Thank you very much. You left the store with a cheerful voice at our basket. Bex, sorry, what the fuck? Bex, so what did you buy? Okay. You're making it sound like it's pretty important. I give you a right smile. What the fuck, that was first place? What do you think I should do now? It's almost noon. At that moment it struck me as I was acting on unlike my usual self. I never asked Madoka that kind of question before. Alright. We entered the first family restaurant that caught our eyes. I'll have the same. To wait, righteous, notice, would you like drinks before food? Yes. Hi. Understood. You ordered medium size today. I don't get as hungry when I take the train, I guess. You'd usually be beyond exhausted by this time we took food breaks when cycling. Most of the time we took care of our hunger with rice balls and sandwiches from convenience stores to save time. I realized it was quite unusual for us to have such a peaceful lunch together. For once, I wasn't too exhausted to talk, but I couldn't think of anything to say. Thank you for waiting. We sipped at our drinks. Come to think of it, chat with friends was quite a strange relationship. If you went out and ate together when you went dating or anything. Most of the time we acted together with a goal of mind. But without one to distract me now, my thoughts strayed to areas where they probably shouldn't have. That often was the reason behind the strange things of discomfort I'd been recently having. Go home? There's nothing else to do. Is there anything fun in this area? I've only ever come here for Nakagawa. Your statement about having... What? but having gone all this way would have lost meaning at this point, but I figured it was best not to point it out yet. Then where do you think we should go? I think we've been going to parks and stuff all the time. Wanna go to the sea or something? I almost choked on my drink. I couldn't think of a convincing way I swallowed, so I answered here with grim honesty. I'm impressed, you know, just... Oh. You guys seem to actually be smiling. You weren't sensing anything, yes, just... He was just surprised to see us in our street clothes. Mm-hmm. Give me a sec. He should have come here on our bikes after all. I didn't want the conversation to end, so I said the first things that came to my mind. Don't you already have it though? Both for summer and winter? Is that what we were talking about? I smiled and cocked my head. We returned to the station and headed to the beach. Yeah. There was a beach within walking distance from our homes, yet we barely even went there. We've been kind of busy with our bikes for the past two or three years. Maybe it was true that people tended to not appreciate the things that were right in front of them. Yeah, I guess so. I told Madoka about it as we reached the somewhat lonely looking beach. I mean, you're kind of taking it for granted, I guess. That's why you kind of don't appreciate it. I don't remember you ever saying you particularly like swimming ice though. What is
that?
She gave me intense stare. She was obviously talking about herself, but okay. Maybe I was, but I truly had no idea what she was trying to say. Am I supposed to? Oh, you cipher with me, I guess? We cycle together? No, wait, I'm the one who has to keep an eye out for things you keep forgetting. So it's more like I'm babysitting you at times instead of... That'd be unfortunate. I ended up responding seriously. I knew she was kidding, but... Madoka had a shocked look on her face as she looked at me. But smile soon returned to her face. I know. Yeah! I felt like my face was growing warm again, so I shifted my gaze to his horizon. Maruka seemed to have done the same. I, most likely for the first time in my life, grew conscious of Madoka's presence. And as if I was alone, with a girl... Ah, I forgot to set up the time! Give me a sec. So like... When I started? I didn't save, right? Yeah, I didn't save. But, I guess I... before, I guess. Tobai and I went to the shopping district of school. That said, it wasn't like we had anything particular to do there. We checked out random stores and fiddled with our phones for the most part. Tobai?
Huh?
Do you have a girlfriend? Also, I just thought, because, you know, reasons. He doesn't look 12 years old. He looks like, yeah, he's like 16 or something. Guess not. Why do you sound so uncertain? It's nothing. I just thought of it randomly. That was the truth. But it was also true that I had never talked about these kind of things before, so I couldn't blame Sabaya for getting confused. No? Ah! Don't shout in my ear! Better than the beast? What? What does it even mean?
So...
Huh? I don't. What are you talking about?
Akitsu-san wa?
That was just a childhood friend.
Na, hola. Shita no namae de yonderu kurai da shi. Ore wa shitteru zo. Omae ra gakkou ja hotondo shaberanai kedo, issho ni jidensha nanzo ni noru naka nan da yo na.
Was it the one who told you about that?
Nikitsu wa dōgō hō iihan nan da zo. Omae san ni itteru.
Both of us have our own bikes. You could always try and find one. I gave him a wry smile that he returned with an indignant look. You look like you should be a player, but you actually slow to act.
うちって妙に美人が多いんだよな。え?まずはお前の妹だろ?オッケー。あとは静宮って1個上の先輩に、亀では桐藤とかエリサカとか知らない?
I don't think so. So, Shizumiya. She wouldn't happen to be Kazutaka's older sister?
ああ、そう。そっか。お前ら仲良かったもんな。けど、他はマジで知らないの?学校内じゃちょっと有名だぞ。あ、彼女がいれば興味もないか。
I don't. They've been checking out the girls in the freshman class since the very first day of the year, so he was probably really into this kind of thing.
ああ、あと。
He paused and stared right at me. Yeah, I'm dying to know. Who is this other one? You think so? I thought of reflex. Wait, I remember him saying something along those lines on the first day. Tobias poked me with an elbow. I just asked an honest question, but it may have looked differently for him. I had been a lot less responsive to his provocations last time. But now they actually affected me. There might have been something off with me lately. Not like I necessarily hated this change in myself or anything. You don't? Nah. Wanna go to the arcade?
そうしようぜ。
I used an alarm clock on days I go cycling. It felt kind of uneventful to wake up normally like this. Morning! There was still some time before Miss Miyako and Hatsune would show up. I took some bread and fried an egg to make myself a simple breakfast. I tried to leave as early as possible on days I planned longer trips so I could come back before dusk. The days have grown a bit longer lately, but I still couldn't let my guard down. I couldn't see Madoka anywhere when I left the house. Most of the time she'd be waiting ahead of me, so this was a bit unusual. 2-3 minutes later, the door to Madoka's house opened and Madoka appeared. Mori!
Ohayo.
Let's go.
Chotto matte yo!
Eh?
Ano... 何か私に言うことはないわけ?
You look good? Ah, yeah, because it's her new outfit, right. How could I not? Yeah, nice. Why the colors all? Is it? Ah, no, it's just yeah, it's just from the clothes. Tell you, it sounded like I was supposed to confess something I did behind her back, but. I couldn't remember getting involved in anything of that nature. No? Look, I can't read minds, okay?
エスパーじゃなくても分かるはずだけどな。たった1週間前の話なんだから。
A week ago? Oh, you bought a skirt? Is it? Yeah. Maybe I shouldn't have phrased like that. No,
Oh! I mean,
I'm sorry. I wasn't entirely sure if that warranted an apology though.
ちょっと遅れたのだって、これのせいなんだからね。鏡を見たりして。
From Madoka's perspective, it was probably disappointing that I paid no attention to her sudden change in looks. No, I think it looks good on you.
Shinji, you
don't have to rub it in. But why did you think of buying a skirt all of a sudden? I glanced at her as she saw what and saw that she had a somewhat troubled expression on her face. Yeah. Especially when she's like, you know, ahead of you. You thought you'd get cold? Don't go, it's only going to get warmer from now. I carefully analyzed Madoka's statement as the asphalt road flew by my eyes. In the past I would have brushed it aside without a second thought, but now... Right, you can't wear anything under those bicycle shorts. I was wearing them myself, so I should have known it better than anyone. But it didn't even occur to me until now. I couldn't help but glance at Madoka's side. For some reason, the presence of a skirt only made me more conscious of what wasn't. I had to control myself. But then again, Madoka never seemed to worry about these kind of things until now.
Really?
I never really felt cold with this though. We were riding up a slope, competing to see who'd take the lead. We wouldn't compete much at other times, but there was just something about hills that made it impossible to resist it. I hadn't won against Madoka even once so far, but... I managed to get into the lead today and the distance between us kept increasing little by little. The sound of Madoka's breathing was slowly growing further and further away. I did it! As usual, I almost collapsed upon reaching the goal. Just what I was torturing myself for. But this time, the pain came with a certain kind of pleasure. The taste of victory. Maruga caught up with me after a couple of seconds. You breathed heavily for a while. You sure this hurt wasn't getting in your way? Then, I really won for the first time!
So, ne.
I thought you'd be more frustrated, so now I don't know how to react! Yeah! Oh, shut up. What are you talking about? My master is dead. We decided to take a lunch break with the two boxed lunches from a convenience store. Yeah. Yeah. Even simple rice bowls and sandwiches taste differently in such a beautiful place. Huh? No way! I just got lucky today. I did not almost concern her. Maruka answered me with the same smile as before. I guess so. I turned my gaze to the scenery, feeling kind of unconvinced. Why did I find it so hard to believe Monoko was just telling the truth? I'm thinking of it, we had a similar conversation when we were cycling during the last day of the spring break. If I'm reserved, I just can't beat you. It's pretty depressing to keep losing to a girl, you know. What do you mean? I can't really push myself this hard when I'm alone, so if experience is really the problem, I don't see the gap between us shrinking anytime soon. Back then, I only thought of myself. What if my body was about to change then, so probably was Madoka's as well. It didn't look cool to me back then. Maybe? No. I frantically shook my head. Sure. Munch. I felt like I finally realized what was wrong with me. The answer was simple. Maruka was girl! I never thought of her as one because of how close we were as childhood friends, but they said it wasn't like there was anything I could do about it, whether I realized the answer or not. I turned back after the long break. We've known this hill multiple times now, but there was one thing we always had to watch out for on our way back. I heard a story once of some rider falling to take the turn and going over the guardrails. I didn't know whether it was true or not, give me a sec. I tried looking down over the edge one time and it looked pretty clear that no human could survive that fall. As such, I'd always slow down in this area. Suddenly a wave of anxiety swept over me. I changed the wiring of my brakes just the last day. What if I messed up? I couldn't use the brakes as we went up here without issue. So my fears were completely unfounded, but they still chilled me to my core. Maruka followed me from behind. Yeah, it was. Yeah, bye. I'm going home. I feel like cycling.
じゃあ、このままで。けどお前、一人でもチャリに乗ってるんだな。 Akitsu-san wa nanka bukatsu yatteru ndaro?
Yeah, I've got nothing else to
do. Ore to asonde yo. Kedo, akinai no?
I do get tired going to the arcade every day, yeah?
Ore no hanasu ja nee yo. Tari no koto.
Not really? I'm kind of just riding without thinking much when I'm on my own. So it's a different experience than riding with someone.
So こまで行くとトレーニングとか部活のノリだな。
I guess.
じゃな。
Bye. I headed straight home after parting ways with Sabaya. Okay, that's. Also, I should probably make it like.I guess it's like sound effects. Yeah. Because, yeah, it's cool that it's like, like a jump scare, but it's like, if it's not scary, then like it's just loud and that's annoying. Huh? Again. I jumped in surprise like an idiot, seeing it happen when Sabaya wasn't around.The woman that had been walking toward me from the opposite direction gave me a creeped out look, or so it looked to me. I rolled my eyes to the ground and hurried away. The stupid thing always popped up after I'd forgotten all about it. That was just different. What just happened?I heard a scream, it was probably the woman that passed by me earlier. Then there followed the sound of something soft colliding with something hard and heavy. Most likely a car. I couldn't hear anything at all now. It took me two or three seconds to process these thoughts. That was enough to calm me down and I turned around. Nice. Give me a sec.I felt like I had the winds knocked out of me. I had already steeled myself to what I was about to see, but that didn't reduce my shock and horror one bit. I hardly pulled out my phone out of the bag, but my hands shook so hard I could barely grab it. Feeling like I had to confirm what had happened, I slowly approached the woman as I called 119. Wow. I thought she was just run over, but wow, her head is just like...Yes, I need an ambulance. I think there was a hit and run. But it might be already too late for an ambulance. I don't really know. The head of this person... her head is... The police wanted to hear my story, but since I was underage, they needed my guardian to accompany me. I told them everything I knew with Miss Miyako by my side. Unfortunately, I couldn't tell them what they wanted to know the most, the details of the culprit's car.Kaplitska. Zara was already setting by the time they released me. I'm sorry you had to leave work early because of me.
Nani itteru no?
Miyako gave me a stern look.
Change your fucking tag to Miyako. Miss Miyako.
Shinji-kun, watashi wa anata no okaasan gawari nan da kara. So enryo suru koto mo nai no yo.
Okay. I wasn't conscious of it, but after she mentioned it, I realized it might have sounded a bit too formal. Sorry about that? Oh. I felt kind of dizzy and had trouble walking straight. The scene around me felt distant as though I were in a dream.
Kaerimashou.
Okay. What about Hatsune?
Hatsune-chan?
Should we tell her?
黙っていましょう。学校の子にも言ったりしない方がいいわよ。
OK. Got it. Let's dig in.
いただきます。
Munch. I could barely taste the foods. I was still in shock. Yako's cooking was always delicious, but today it felt bland.
今日の お兄さん、なんか元気がないんだね。風邪？
Not really. I shook my head, I knew Hatsune was worried, but I didn't have the energy to talk.
あと、ママも。今日は疲れた顔をしているような。
ちょっとね、仕事で。
Osmi Sumiyako and I barely talked, making this the quietest dinner we'd ever had. Only the sounds of TV filled the room. We almost always had the news on during breakfast and dinner. Well, next story, police responding to a pedestrian fatality in Sakura no Mori city this afternoon. She had been declared dead at the scene when pandemics arrived. From the markings on the road, police believed this to be a hit and run incident. Hatsune frowned as the reporter mentioned the area of the incident. Accident.
Honto, konna michi tobasu yona tokoro dewa nai no ni ne.
Hidoi.
Futari mo michi o aruku toki wa kii o tsukenai to dame yo. Kochi wa wakatte ite mo, achi wa wakatte inai koto nanka yoku aru nda kara.
Okay. Though I'd see them off the apartment every day, tonight I was far more cautious of my surroundings. There were barely any cars in this area, so I waited at night. I hope the bastard gets caught.
So, ne?
Honey?
Ah, I'm talking about that hit and run incident on the news earlier.
Oh.
Hatsune gave me a somewhat confused nod. It must have been a bit unnatural to bring that up.
それじゃ、バイバイ。
See you.
おやすみ。
I'm home. My whole body felt heavy. I didn't know that woman, but seeing her like that must have affected me more than I thought. I didn't want anyone else to die around me. I'd already had more than enough of that with my parents.I thought to go straight to bed, but I took a bus a bit earlier than usual. Wait, what? Ah, so I took. I said but. So I took a bus a bit earlier than usual, yeah. Fuck, sorry. There was a message from Madoka on my phone. I could have told her I was sleeping and went straight to bed, but I kind of felt like seeing her face today.Yeah, I thought about going to bed early. I shook my head, but it didn't seem like it goes through to her.
あんまり辛くなったら言いなさいよ。私、そっちに行ってあげるから。それとも…
I shook my head again. I guess I can tell her. I suddenly felt like telling her everything. I'm not sick. Actually, what happened was... Yeah, I hope they don't take too long to catch the culprits.You've got to be careful too, it's even more dangerous when you're on a bike.
そうだね。
Anyway, I think I'll go to bed already.
うん、おやすみ。
Good night. I kind of broke my promise with Miss Miyako, but I felt like I could trust Madoka with this. With this talking about, it definitely made me feel better.
あんまり辛くなったら言いなさいよ。私、そっちに行ってあげるから。
Madoka seemed to have quite a kind side to her. And I never thought much of it before. Good morning!
Ohayo! Shinji-kun, kinou no hannin tsukamatta mitai yo.
Now that was fast. Now I see.
Ima chōdo nagareteru no.
I sat down at the table and looked at the TV. According to the police, the suspect claims that he felt as though he were possessed. I wonder if he's one of those wannabe street racers. I turned my eyes to the TV, but they had already moved on to a different story. Then, was it a murder? He felt as though he were possessed? What was that even supposed to mean?
Mattaku. 妙な人も世の中にはいるものよ.
Yeah. At that moment, a strange feeling overtook me. It was like an odd sense of discomfort, like a step of stake suddenly disappearing underfoot. I've lived in Sakura Mori all my life. I thought I knew all there was to know about it. It's every nook and cranny. But now I felt as though it had a sight that I never witnessed before. Okay, I'm gonna take a break here, I guess. So, yeah, that's safe. And yeah, see you in a few minutes.